Okay, so Ashley's pushing me into this because she's being impatient.
And I'm sorry if this shakes a lot. I've never held a camera like this.
That too. So basically what I'm going to show you guys is the VR setup I got here. If you guys like VR, then you know what it is. If you don't, it stands for virtual reality, and that's what it is. You put the headset on, and you're in the game world, playing whatever game or doing whatever you're doing. Like, you're actually in the game versus just looking at a 2D. It's like a 3D game. That's a good way to describe it. So, obviously you need a TV. That's important. Not really great importance, but it is nice for people that are not playing to sit there and watch it. You'll need a computer, if you can see it down here. Ours kind of hides down here. We ended up having to buy this whole setup brand new. I didn't have a computer. They recommend having basically a high graphics card on your computer. I tried to buy this one from Best Buy. It's actually the lowest graphics card one I could have bought at the time, and it still cost me like $900. It doesn't really have a problem running them though. That's usually what people get into, is because they take so much graphics enabled stuff to run these games that they start lagging and stuff. I haven't really noticed that an issue with our computer, which is sweet because it costs a lot of money to upgrade this shit. So basically, that's a close up high. What you get, let me unplug it. Oh, I'll leave it plugged in. Is this guy right here. So when you put this on your head, you can kind of see in there now, but it shows a white screen. You basically use this guy back here, and it expands and stretches this piece out so you can put it over your head comfortably. Then your ear heads come down, and then they kind of stretch in and out.
Headphones.
Earphones. One on each side, of course. You got a fancy button right here. Then all that does is basically pulls the front of the headset in and out. Basically makes it more like, either if you pull all the way back, it's a full view. You push it out, it's kind of like a zoomed view. It focuses it more like a fisheye look, whatever you want to call it. And then this little wheelie thing right here kind of controls how far apart your eye lenses are. I've never actually messed with that, which might not be a bad idea because I know my eyes are kind of close together compared to most people, so are hers, but I leave it how it is. Traditionally, on the back of this thing, you'd have three cords. Why did I put it away? Plugs in right here, and you'd have three core, or one, okay, so this is the Vive Pro. I did originally, no, I didn't, never had it, but the original Vive had three cords that ran up. The Vive Pro works off of one cord that used to come all the way down here, and then it would be a long-ass cord that trailed into the back of your PC. And that's how it comes when you buy it from stock. You can't buy these in store, which is kind of stupid. I just found another button on the side of the headset that I never knew was there.
Maybe that's the one that does the lens look.
Nope. It's a screenshot.
Oh.
Anyway. So apparently that side button takes a picture of what you're playing. She's talking about, there's a thing that basically, if you set it up right, which I haven't figured out how, it actually lets you look through the device. Which would be kind of handy if you're in a game playing all by yourself. You can kind of see where you're at, look at something real quickly out of the game without taking the whole damn headset off. So that really ruins the immersion. But basically, this one's been retrofitted with this little fancy box. And what this does is, albeit one cable and a power box to keep this thing constantly charged, it makes it wireless. So, I mean, I guess the answer is it's not true wireless because you still have the one cord that has to be plugged in. People have these, the normal one actually comes with like a clip. I've seen people be able to like clip them on. You can actually upgrade the whole headset. So you can buy one of these and replace the whole thing. So you can put your own headphones through it. And most people that did that, they had a little spot right here you could clip this on. That way it was out of your way. The only real enthused audio game I really play is a game called Beat Saber, so I haven't really worried too much about the headphones because honestly don't make a lot of difference when you're playing the games. These are the original controllers that come up. So basically you had grip buttons on the side, kind of like a PlayStation, your button to connect, and then your trigger back here and your trackpad. Most of the time the grip, you know, you're shooting, you're picking up, and this kind of moves you. And a lot of these games, a few of them you can walk in, but most of them you actually kind of point where you want to go, release the button, and it puts a little arrow, and you release it, and it kind of transports you to the game, I guess, so you don't get dizzy or whatever. But these are the stock controllers that come with it. Obviously, there's two, one for each hand. I don't use it anymore, though, because I recently got these. These are part of the newest system, so there's a new Valve Index system that's out now, but it's got the highest graphics, basically, headset you can get, and it came with these guys. These are called knuckle controllers. Basically, the only difference on these guys is they have a few more buttons, A and B. The trackpad still works, but it's finger-sensitive, or finger-sensing. So basically, in most of these games, if you actually put your three fingers down, your one finger up there, one like this, you close your hand. So in these games, when it says to grab something, instead of hitting the grip button on the side that was there beforehand, you actually have to grip it. Half the time, I forget the fact that this button is actually one of your finger sensors. So when I do it, I'm like sitting there like this, and like it doesn't, the middle finger just shows it's pointing up. It doesn't obviously get it completely. I mean, it can't tell when you're like bending your hand like this because you obviously don't have fingers on it. But I like these ones because once you get them on there, you slide your hand through there and you have a little thing to basically tighten it, and then that releases it. It's kind of nice because then you feel like when you're playing, you're not going to lose it. You don't want to hold on the remote 24/7. You can put it down. Obviously, there's two of those. This system uses a lot of charger cables. Between having to charge, I bought a second battery, so there's one already over there charging. Basically, a little light to show you how many battery bars you have. Between having to charge the two remotes separately, the two batteries separately, it does take up a lot of USB points out here. The other controllers I have that originally came with the system actually have two USB controllers that are plugged right into the box down there, which reminds me, I could probably unplug them now, but I'll leave them there. But they actually just had like a AC adapter with the cord that I would plug in. These new ones don't. They come with USBs. The only easy USB spot I can get to on my computer is on the top of it here. There's like three or four little USB spots, but I don't really want to leave these ones plugged in 24/7. So basically, once you get into the computer system here, your first thing with this little guy up here that makes it wireless is it has you, once you get it all set up, wrapped around all the cords reconfigured, it has to download this app. It's a wireless little dongle. You have to install a PCI card in the back of your computer to make sure it works. And what that does is powers this guy to connect with the system. So once you open it, you hit this little triangle on the top of here, and it's basically like your on button. Then it says it's synced, ready to go. You'll download Vive port, which is what originally comes with it, and then it directs you to download Steam. So when you get Steam uploaded, it's what turns on your major VR system. So in the bottom of your computers, once you have it uploaded, you always have, go away, this little icon right here that shows you basically that everything is working. It shows your headset is tracking, shows your remotes are,
ours aren't on.
Ours aren't on. Normally the blue. I was like, what? And then the base stations. So basically, the cameras and the setup are pretty simple. You've got one over on that corner, and then we've got one sitting right behind you right there. We recently ended up actually getting a carpet, or our household got a new living room carpet. So we cheated and took this carpet out here, which actually makes it really nice because, as you can tell, we're playing in the garage. It gets cold out here and your feet get sore. So this carpet almost, I mean, the edges of this carpet are two basically your cameras. Why that's important is because when you're playing the game, basically it puts up like a fake wall barrier. So when you get too close to the edge, you'll see basically like a green looking wall type thing to tell you to back up or you're going to hit something. Now, traditionally, you set them at least a foot away from any of your things you might hit. When I traced this room out originally, I went all the way up to right where you could go. So there are some times that I'm playing and I get too far into it and accidentally hit something. Like the toolbox, it has about 6 new dents for me in this last year. Don't judge. But the other camera, when you set these up, basically the first thing it'll have you do is get on the system and run like a room setup tutorial. It'll ask if you're going to sit, which is an option. A lot of people who don't have big rooms, they'll sit in their computer chair and play. I already have the PlayStation VR, which, Google it, it's kind of the same idea. But in that one, most of the games, you could only sit, you couldn't move around. So I didn't obviously want to get this on here just to sit. So the camera is basically, once you get into it, you choose standing, and then it has you basically put the cameras on the floor to adjust how far your floor is going to be down, has you put the cameras basically, and then you just take the trigger button on that and draw your outline, and that's what the box is once you get inside the system. So once you get all that set up, that would be done through the Vive port app. So this is the main app that comes with the Vive, obviously. Vive port, you get it? Okay, good. So when you're in this guy, you have little sections up here where you can download stuff. You can sit and literally get Netflix on this thing and watch Netflix. And they put you on a couch and you're watching Netflix and like a 52-inch screen in front of you. People have tried it. I have not, but people have. Viveport isn't really a place. They have games on here you can buy, but if you look, a lot of these symbols will show this little like infinity sign, and that's because Viveport kind of runs off of what was that called? PlayStation kind of had like a thing instead of Redbox before it got big, you know, like a subscription type thing. So you pay for it monthly and then you can download up to 5 titles each month. And then you have to restart and either re-download new ones or delete old ones to get new ones. PlayStation did something like that. So to Netflix, kind of the same idea on this. You download the games you want and then get them on there. But when you load up these game systems, basically in your library, it'll show you all the games that you own on this side. At least for the Viveport side of things. This is also, pause for effect.
Why don't you show them Steam, then you can see it going into it. So they can see that. Well, I mean, because you still, it's, I guess, whatever.
Basically, when you're in this game system, you can kind of see I'm cheating using the headset just to go around, but they kind of have little startup menus and you're in like your own little world. Most of the time when you play, that's good to know. Most of the time when you're playing this system, I don't really jump into this game at all. Because once you're in the system, I'll get it up and going, but you'll see you kind of, they put you in like a little dojo room where you can select the games from the headset, which is nice because that means you really never have to leave VR unless you have to, you know, go to the bathroom or something stupid like that. Not that using the bathroom stupid, I'm just saying. And then this one is Steam. So Steam isn't really a new thing. Actually, a lot of people use like computer games and stuff, download stuff off of Steam all the time. It was new to me though because I've never been a computer game player. But basically, Steam has a section in here where you go to games, and now you can look up specifically virtual reality games. So games that work only for VR system headsets. It scrolls through, you can download and search by. Look it up specifically by what you have. Like I said, I don't own the Valve Index. This is actually the HTC Vive, but because it is a Valve Index controllers, if I looked it up specifically by Valve Index, it would give me games that specifically work with the finger touch sensing on these controllers. These controllers, we're talking about setup here, so the computer was $1,000. All the VR stuff was about $1,300. I just recently spent another $300 for 2 controllers, which is why I wasn't super worried about the headset, because once again, a lot of these games are not like live action. You're in like animation type stuff, so I didn't really worry about like how good it looked at you. I know, I stopped talking. Basically, once you're in here, so Steam is one of the main places you can get gift cards for, so I only specifically buy my games off of Steam, but they automatically get loaded into the Viveport library when you're doing it, so I just got this for Christmas, which is why I had one on file. So I just bought 3 new games, but once you're into this, I don't like how Steam looks when you're looking at your games because they're set up like that. Even when I'm out of the game, I'll always go to Viveport.
Click the little square icon next to the home symbol.
What do you mean?
Go up. Up. Oh.
It's just like a collections thing. But I don't like how it's like a list view, I guess. And part of me is just because I haven't like played them all, so I get kind of confused on what they look like. Most of the time, Steam is shut down when I play. I specifically play off of this. So, Viveport was that thing that you were looking at for like 10 seconds. If I remember right, you look like you're in like a Tron type airport and you can talk to people and like download things off of there and look at videos and stuff. I mean, I haven't gone on there in forever, but. Alright. So, I can scroll through and show you 1,000 games I own, and that might not be fun for you because you're not going to know what any of them are, but I have about 97 games on here. Three or four of them are fairly new games, but I'm just going to put it on the plane. So if it doesn't work, she can come over here and click it on, but we'll try to make sure not only you can, she can look at me, but look at what you're gonna view on the screen. So basically, once I start playing, which you can't see it right, actually I can do it from right here. Make her do it. She's got a recording device. We also don't have a mouse pad out here, so this is really stupid. So basically, that'll stay on there so you guys can kind of see what I'm looking at. And then I'm going to go ahead and jump in the game and just pick a few. I'll kind of talk about them as they play them, I guess. So, you're supposed to use a nice cloth. I don't ever do that. I use my shirt, which is probably bad for the lens, but there it is. You basically put your head into it, pull it over, get it on your face, and then this back thing, like I said, just tightens it down. This game is kind of particular. You kind of got to find a sweet spot when you're playing. As stupid as that sounds, like it doesn't sit level.
I've noticed if it's higher than your eyeballs, it seems to be more clear. But not like you, like a little bit just higher.
So like I said, if you can see it, this kind of pulls it in and out. I don't know if it shows what I'm looking at in the game or not when I do it, but that little dial, I thought was the
control. It does, it has a rear delay.
Was to control your eyeballs, but it's not. And that button over here that I just found talking to you, take screenshots. That's probably the only part about this that sucks, is trying to find your remote when your head sits on. And I need the battery. Thanks, Ashley. Where are you going?
Push over this damn chair. It's always in the way.
So, can you see what I'm playing right now?
Yeah.
So, does it show you the green?
Yeah, you can see the green outline.
So if you look, that space I was talking about that you actually follow with the cursor is this wall. So once you're in the game, it's obviously not there until you get too close to your playing edge, and then it shows a green wall so you don't pass. Basically, you don't pass it or punch something over here. As you can see, most of the time, my hand doesn't really hit anything sticking out from it. I believe this is the garage. The workbench side is a little bit close over here, but not by much. So we're gonna power these on. There's a little button up here that does it. And if you look, it'll show them in the game. So kind of shows what your finger's tracking, the remote's moving, the button's hitting. Shows a little thumb on each side so you know what you're doing. It even shows the battery charger on there. So we're gonna hit. This button takes you to your home screen. So the weird thing about this is what you're probably looking at right now. And I have an option, I can literally go to my desktop and see what I'm looking at in the game. Yes, it does do that every time unless I exit out of it. It's trippy and cool. But let's just go home for the sake of it. So if you looked at that system, you should have seen this icon. And literally that's what it's called. There's home. You can change it. Like I said, this one's more like a little dojo looking thing. So on most of these games, on the original style thing, you have this little flat button up here that you would hit where you want to go and then release it and it would take you there. On these ones, you use the thumbstick the same way. So on most of these games, you'll just kind of point and release where you want to go. And then you're in walking around. So this isn't really a game. This is just like a setup to the game. You can actually customize this whole area, which I really haven't done, but you could. So once you get into your home system, here's where you kind of pick up games. So a lot of these top ones are brand new games. Let's see. I don't really know if I want to show you every game. Maybe there's a video where I'll do that eventually and go through all my games. Because if I did it now, I mean, I've tried to play all these games in a row and it took me a good 4 hours, so
I would suggest picking the best. How do I put that?
I'll show you some of my favorites.
There you go.
There you go. Okay, so let's just start out with the one where the dorky is. So this is one of the first games that ever came out with the system. It's called The Lab. If you can't see it, it's called The Lab. There is a camera pointed on top of TV, which I think is over here somewhere, that basically connects with this little wireless thing. That way it kind of senses me in the game space. There's not usually too big of a delay on these games. Usually. If you can see my hands right now, this is one of the few games that use the finger tracking. So as you put each finger down, you can kind of see it gripping onto the controllers.
Amber, do me a favor and then hug behind you a little bit more.
Step back?
Yes. Keep going. You're like 2 feet away, but that way I can get you and the video.
So you can see me and the TV screen, you mean?
Mm-hmm.
We'll see how all this works. So anyway, like I was saying, this was kind of a startup game that came with it. If you guys have
a... It was like a demo game.
Right. If you ever played the PlayStation when they first started, there was always these games that came out. There was like a little demo. That's what all these were. So basically, this one was kind of a wizarding one. This one was just kind of like a walking one. Oh, hell. I'll show you. It's Snapalogjajoka School National Park in Iceland. I'm pretty sure I just butchered that, but as you... Whoa! Okay, don't let me freak you out, people, but this is actually new to me. Every time I've ever played this game, it's looked different. They added a new level. So as you can see, basically, it kind of puts you in here. Little X, like I said, is how you move. So there's only... In this game, you can't really free move. You're kind of stuck moving where it tells you to move. So it looks like...
It's letting you walk around the rocks to look at it.
Yeah, it looks like that's as far as I can go. It is animated, so I mean, this one looks pretty realistic, actually, for a video game. These things are kind of tricky, because when you're playing the screens and stuff, you don't really see what you can see from in here. And yes, you do have, like, a...
It's a doggy.
A robotic doggy, I guess. You're supposed to fetch. See any fetches. You can pet them, you can play with them in each one of these little levels. I mean, I have my own dog, but it is kind of entertaining to do it with a robotic one. Alright, anyway. If you grab the ball and basically put it towards you, it's what puts you back. Sorry, I'm showing you the butt crack. Anyway, what puts you back to the main level, so to speak. So, I'm just going to show you those. That one's pretty fun. I'll be honest, I can never remember what you do in this one. You're in like a little room and you have to do something. This one you're like a midget in like a little tiny wizard looking room. This one you repair your robots. They actually made a full edge version of it, but I don't find it that entertaining. This is the one she likes. It's like, I mean, if you can see what I'm looking at, it's a slingshot game. Basically, the point is to break all this crap, and the more damage you take on this game, well, the better. So you grab your little remote, adjust this thing for where you want to go. I always just make it all the way down because it's easier for me to adjust that way. Walk up, wait till they load it. Walk up, grab the thing, and then basically if you look what I'm looking at, you got to break all these little blue boxes. The more you break, the more boxes you get. I usually don't actually break the boxes. I always go for the...
I go for the TNTs.
Yeah. I don't go for the individual boxes. I always go for the TNTs for some reason. And if you look, it's kind of like Angry Birds. It'll tell you what you shot beforehand. So if you take it to the same spot you were just at, go up a little bit, you know, what you're aiming on. You can kind of cheat. This game's pretty entertaining, but I mean... The most I've ever gotten is like 9 balls off in this thing, and I don't know if there's any levels past it. Basically, if you look, you gotta destroy each one of these little blue boxes as you're going down. That was effective. Sarcastic, of course. Those little blue boxes. And each time you destroy a box, you get a new ball.
You know, actually, it's not the boxes. So the blue ones, if you watch, look at her next ball she's gonna get. You just, the plan is just to destroy it, but if you knock the blue one, the next ball you get is a blue ball that'll show you where it's going to shoot. Do you see the, I'm going to zoom in on that. Do you see the blue thing where it forecasts? then it lets you see where you're going to shoot. So the blue ones are not really the point of the game. It's just more like it gives you another type of ball to help you shoot. Boom. See, and then it goes back to the black where it doesn't have the aim. And you can see that how many balls she has by the on top of the little pad right there.
Right there, it shows me I have two. If you look up there, it'll also show two balls up there. Would you please? Sorry, got it. So if you look, you're basically obviously in a warehouse. You can move around. I mean, yeah, whatever. If you kind of move, you can pick things up and kind of interact with stuff here. I mean, there's not really much. The robot's beeping out, but...
I was like, why is it beatboxing?
It's this robot. He's a music robot. Close. Anyway, let's go back and show you the last one on here, which is my personal favorite, but probably the most exhausting because I have really bad aim. But it, if you can't tell by kind of what it looks like and you see arrows, that's basically what it is. There's quite a few games ever since this one came out. This is actually, if you look it up, this is the most popular one still, but there's quite a few longbow arrow type games. This one I just kind of like the animation of. I mean, it's pretty simple idea. Obviously, it's just a crossbow game, but basically the point is not to let all those guys go through that door, need a little bit of a help, and then if you shoot those balloons, like that was such a great aim, you get 5% health that kind of loads back up to your door health. I'm just trying to show you what a balloon does, but like I said, my aim sometimes isn't very good.
I'm going to zoom in on the game a little bit just so you can see how the level is. And again, it feels a lot different when you're actually in it playing. You shoot them, they turn into balloons. Catch the balloons, it builds up your gate health. They have bombs around. And you're on a kind of a little balcony. So if you look at her when she bends over it, she literally is on top of that.
You can play with the flame.
I just recently learned that.
A light up arrow. These are actually kind of handy with the guys with the shield, because it actually lights them on fire if they don't drop the shield. Or they at least drop the shield. You'll notice when you play these games, the more you play...
And it moves through waves, so if you saw that, 4 through 8. And it'll keep going. I mean, until you die.
So yeah, 4 through 8 is what I'm at right now. Once you get to 8, it actually still does keep moving. See, there you go. 5 points if you get a balloon, which basically re-gets your gate and health right there. Obviously, no one's actually gone to my gate yet, so there's not really any health to worry about, but that is an option. Die! Here, I'll show you. So if you look, each the guy on TNT, if you've ever seen, I don't know, any kind of old medieval or even not to geek out, but Hunchback, basically those two targets pour like hot molten lava. That'll kill your target. I don't know why this game is so entertaining, but it is, but it's also very tiring on your own. I mean, granted, you could probably guess that, but I've never actually shot a bow and arrow in my life, so... See? yesterday, and then you defeated it, and that's your wave number, and you can kind of play around and shoot those, or if you want to keep playing, you shoot that idiot, which I promise I'm trying. Wow! Jesus.
Pardon my language.
If you look, the finger traction actually works on this, but if you let go, you actually let go of it, basically grab it, put the trigger on top. Just gonna try to show you the, I'm not gonna keep playing, but I'll show you what the little things do. So that shoots down that crap with the atom on fire.
Pretty much lava is the idea.
Same thing with that side. You only get them for each wave though, so if you notice the waves are in sections, they'll go endlessly if you can play that long. Basically, every time you hit, so like when I hit wave 16, it'll reset all these bombs and stuff. So they're actually pretty good use, and the fire, like I said, is something I recently discovered, which really helps with the armor.
And as you go along, the guys get, you know, more armor, or they start doing weird-ass little jumps, and...
Alright. So if you hit that little home button again, we'll go back to the game's home. Even though I'm in my home, but you know what I mean. Can you still see both of us?
Yeah, you're a little far out of the frame.
Better?
That's better.
So, another one that's kind of a pretty popular one on here is called Beat Saber. If you've ever played any kind of Guitar Hero type of game, you get the general idea. You're hitting boxes as they come at you at the right time.
And the right direction.
And the right direction. And this difference, though, instead of using guitar chords or whatever, Beat Saber. This one's always a little glitchy when I start up for some reason, so don't pay any mind to this. Give it a second, see what I do. But in this one, you actually play with lightsabers.
You can actually customize it to play with anything. But it comes with the lightsabers. Get it? Beat Saber. Lightsaber.
Okay, now it's finally woken up. So, there's tons of songs on here. Like, you can hear the audio that I'm listening to on that side. That are like preloaded songs. So Escape was one of my favorite songs when I first started playing. So when this game first came out, it's still glitching a little bit, so I'm sorry if I lose this quick. This is the only game that sometimes I have a problem with when it glitches. But I do have a game that I'm trying to download in the background, which does not help this. But if you look, basically it's a straight on view. Each color is in each hand, so you got the blue on your right, red on the left, and basically you're gonna try to hit the blocks in the direction they come. The nice thing is actually on that PC, if you look, there's actually something called Beat Drop, which is a way to download the songs that you wanna play. So if I get this thing to load, don't judge me for what's on here, but if you can get them to play, you can kind of play with your own music. There's a bunch of weird songs we've got on here, I'm not gonna lie. Let's see. Hey, look, Shut Up and Dance.
Ha!
Alright. Ashley just done this song because we originally had it and I had to delete everything. I deleted it by accident, so I had to re-download it. This is probably going to end pretty quickly. I don't know why it's so glitchy, but it is. This is probably the only game that I've actually run into that has this problem. So if you look, they got little walls in them that you actually got to dodge and duck in between. You can adjust the height on this thing. That way you're not so low. And the blocks come out, or should come out on tempo if someone made the song right. Games that everyone says is their favorite audio game on here. I can completely agree to that. When I play this game, I mean, I can play it for a couple hours plus straight, and I'm sweating and dying and hot, but I'm still entertained because the audio on these aren't bad. They pump through your earrings, right? Earrings. Headphones. Excuse me. Headphones. So you go right back there. We'll go home again. Like I said, eventually I might do a video showing you my games, but for the day I was trying to show you some different techniques you can do. So, you saw the lab one was kind of animated, that one was kind of animated. They have different types of things on here, so let's see. Let's find an experience, not so much a game. Hold on. So, though, a lot of these are actual, like, games. A lot of them are shooter or, like, think straight games type stuff. Then I got a few of them on here that are just what I classify in my mind as experiences. I got an Everest one that I would have showed you guys, but they do a lot of talking. It's like a Discovery Everest one, so there's a lot of information in it, which is all fun, but not really fun in showing what you're doing. This is another one I got off of that actual Vive port thing. That subscription thing I was showing you. See, it's warning you right off the back. It's seated. I don't really care. I'm going to stand because I don't really have a seat out here. And I love to do it. So if you look, obviously, I mean, none of this is rocket science to figure out. It's called spacewalk, but
feeling good. I'm ready in the Quest airlock, waiting for instructions.
Good. I'm now activating your helmet HUD.
Affirmative, Mission Control. I can see it booting up now.
Alright. Try moving around the airlock. You can grab onto the yellow handlebars to push yourself around. Gently pushing yourself off walls is a valid way of moving your body as well. Grab handles with one hand to translate yourself around. Use two hands to change your orientation.
So basically, this one's kind of, it's taken me a while to get this one down because it is gravity and I really suck at it, but you basically grip with your back thumb, which last time I played this game, I did not realize that, and so it made this take like an extra 20 minutes to do, but you've got a trigger is kind of your hand button, and then it'll help you kind of move along, so I'm just trying to get to the actual, like, meat of the game, I guess you'd say. Come on, man. There.
When you're ready, climb out of the habit you feel first. You'll see the Canadar ready to pick you up for your task on the worksite.
Copy that, Mission Control. Adjusting my position now to lock feet onto the Canadar platform.
Last time I did this, just took me 30 minutes to get hooked up because I could not figure out how to use the controls. But yeah, this is what I would probably say would be just like an experience. Obviously, this one's a little weird because you've actually got the space helmet on, so your peripheral's not really there. But you can look out. I mean, eventually this game kind of gets you. Some of these games give you a little bit of vertigo, I'm not going to lie. It gets you to the other side of the ship where you're kind of crawling along. You basically do like 3 or 4 repair type things and then the game's done. And you end up with like an Aurora Borealis you can see in space, but this is another one of those games. It's like a recent one I got that's fairly entertaining to go through just because the views are pretty cool. The end of it's actually the best view, but it does take a little while to go through, so I'm not going to sit there and show you all of it, but once you get to the end of it, like I said, there's a pretty cool like scene in the sky. Right now, I don't know if you can see what I'm looking at, but they call this like the way station. It's kind of what plays in between stuff, so you can actually customize that. Right before you guys were on here, I was actually on like a star type one. Let's see, what's another popular one? This is more of an action one, but I like this one. So I don't know if you guys ever played like Wii Sports or anything like that, but this is basically one of the, it's a boxing game that's based off the new movie that came out. I've never actually seen any Rocky movies, don't shoot me. Or any Creed, or the Creed movie, once again, sorry. But I do like boxing games. This one's a little bit different in the fact that, which I like it, is because of the fact that you can actually, I mean, you're moving in real life. So if you look, you know, you can see the mittens. I actually, the other remote that
the
you
gloves.
Yeah, sorry, gloves. Boxing gloves. So if you actually looked at those other remotes I showed you, they were long sticks. So when you hit, sometimes I like hit them on top of each other. I don't really have that problem playing this, which is pretty cool. But as you're loading up in this thing, basically, it's like a little gym. So you can go into this thing and go to exercises, and it'll like have you run on the treadmill and punch a little dummy and, you know, like actual boxing sizes. I don't know if you can see them, but that's actually Rocky over there. It's the rest of Sharon, whatever. But I'm just for the demo purposes, just gonna play. Let's play against Rocky. No, play. I'll play as him against Rocky. So if you go through it, basically, you can kind of choose where you want to fight on each one. We'll go to Washington. It's the closest one, right? Then you go to Mexico. But there's a little campaign mode of this. So far away, I can tell the campaign mode is you, like, go into a boxing match and battle them. And then Rocky's like, hey, you got to get a little better. You got to do some training. Let's get you back in the shop. And then you do, like, a little organized exercise. So you can see him. I mean, you can kind of see him. But that's obviously Rocky. He's supposed to be a coach. The game kind of starts up and says, you know, in the blue corner there's this guy, and in the red corner there's this guy, and then they'll show you kind of stats about them. These are actually based off of real players, or these real players in the show. So when you're doing this game, basically your trackpad is kind of how you run, so it's just doing that motion to get over to him. He looks like he's drugged. My leg looks old. Sloppy too. I claim no victory in the fact that I'm any good at this. Oh! Kind of put your hands back up. As the game shows you, if you get knocked out, it'll kind of show you what to do, but would you give me off? Cool thing about this game is it actually like feels how hard you're punching. So if you actually want to do anything, you actually gotta get into it. Oh! I think Rocky might actually win this. Why are there two Rockies? I'm not gonna lie, this game is kind of tiring. I mean, you play like one or two rounds and you're like, yeah, I saw people box for exercise. Thing I won. Good job. No exciting them. There you go. Yeah, you can go through and it kind of tells you the stats, how well you play. No one saw that. And I'm the So right now you'll notice you can see what I'm playing and hear what I'm hearing because you can actually mirror the audio and the visuals from what I'm doing. Brother Sunshine is another big one on here, but I'm not even going to try because I die instantly because I'm really bad with aiming and headshots. And basically, you're shooting zombies, so if you don't get a headshot, you're screwed. Obviously, this wouldn't be complete without a few carnival-ish games, so I don't have any. There was one I had originally that was like an F1 carnival. You could sit on like horses and swings and stuff like that, which was pretty cool, but it was really boring and cartoony, so it didn't really keep your attention. This one, I like this one, but you gotta buy a lot of games in this one. It's not like you get all the games and things. That's the other thing about VR is a lot of the games are like, you know, games you get on your phone. If you want to play this one world, you're good. Anything else, you're kind of screwed.
This one does say it's a demo too.
Yeah, I can buy the real version, but you gotta buy each level individually. And it's like $3 and...
You'd rather actually play for a roller coaster.
Yeah. Not that we have any near us, but yeah. If it ever loads. Does the screen say anything?
No, it shows that it's trying to start up.
So it's kind of a nice thing, because like I said, originally you had a cord on your back, so I can hear a voice over there. So the TV is like behind me right here. So you'd basically be playing, and if you were doing like something like that, you'd have this cord behind you that you'd be pulling at your head and be trying to step over and stuff. Obviously, you don't really have that problem with this behind you. Alright, that's not gonna work, so we're gonna try So as you can see, you can kind of actually get into what you're looking at on there. Like, I can do Steam the same way I do the other one and kind of go through and see what games I got and all that. What are you doing? This is kind of a cool game. Whoa.
You had to click play for some reason. On the actual thing.
Oh, this isn't the one I thought it was.
That's great.
Whoa! So, the visuals in this one kind of sucks, I'm not gonna lie. It's very animated, but you get the idea. You're on a roller coaster, you can kind of look around. I got another one, which is what I thought this one was, where the visuals look better, but I mean, it is pretty cool. These particular games kind of give me vertigo sometimes, especially not at this particular one because it's always one track. But some of them I have you go backwards, and so you're like, whoa! And then by the time you step back down, you're like, uh-oh. Oh, if you're afraid of heights, this is probably not a good system to play. There's a lot of height-oriented games on here. This reminds me of a theme song from some movie, but I can't. Jesus! And there's it. This is a fairly new game I downloaded that I actually just paid for because it was supposed to be the popularest game to play with the knuckle and the finger controller, whatever you want to call it. It is pretty entertaining. It's Blade and Sorcery, so obviously it's a sorcery game. Basically, one hand kind of controls magic abilities, and right now all I've got is lightning, and I can never figure out how to make it work. And then you basically have a sword in the other hand, so there's like little games to play. Hold on, I'll get into it. I'll show you this one and kind of let it be the last one. Like I said, maybe I'll go through and do like a video of like everything I own when Ashley's not out here because she gets bored of these type of videos. But It is pretty entertaining. I mean, for the fact that you can stay in the game, and you don't have to leave the game ever, and play all these games, I mean, you really feel like you're in it sometimes. I mean, I can spend hours out here playing them, and she doesn't get as into it as I do. I mean, she really likes the beat table game, that's about it. I made my own avatar with really blue eyes, which I keep saying I'm gonna fix, but I haven't. But if you look, this is kind of a cool space to show it, but can you see what I'm doing?
Yeah.
So if you look, my hands are actually open. You know, you put your thumb on, they can track with thumb, the front finger, and your three fingers. Except for that one, because I don't have it down all the way. Sometimes these don't work, so usually they have like a sensing mode where they say like, hold it for 3 or 4 seconds and then release, and then do it again, and you can kind of, it'll work better. But as you can see, the ones on the bottom are a little bit touchy, the one on the top, but this type of sensing isn't the same on all of the games, so a little backwards. This game also has got basically like force powers, if you will. You can kind of pull stuff up and play it, but for now, let's play that one. I don't even know which one I just chose, but we're going to go this one. So this isn't really like a sword fighting game in the typical sense where like you're on this big, I just played this one last time. Where you're on like some big quest or anything like that. It's a wave type game, so this game's kind of cool in the fact that each blade or weapon of your choice, so to speak, they actually try to implement real game physics, which in their world just means they slow it down. So to make these actually like feel like you're actually going to hit them fast enough, you have to then use two hands like you would in real life, and they're a little bit slower. That's usually why I stick with the sword. I mean, I've tried the other tools and stuff, but I prefer the sword. All right, let's go. Did I just drop the sword? Yes, I did. That ain't gonna help much. All right, let's go find the book. You don't actually have to walk that way, but I just played a game where that's what you did, and now my mind's kind of on it. So we'll just do a quick one to show you, and then I'll get out of this thing and talk a little bit, and we'll call it good. Like I said, I might show you an actual video at one point, but basically, if you look, make sure no one's behind you before I do this. So basically, that'll kind of pull up like that, a menu. Most of these games are not full-fledged. Like, it's not like PlayStation where you're going to be playing hours of gaming, because they don't really have any like full 5, 6, 7 hour campaigns like you do in PlayStation. A lot of these are like the another game that I didn't show you, which is called Super Hot. It's a pretty popular game too. It's a shooting game with like the idea of Matrix, so it's like a strategy game too. So they don't move unless you move, which makes it pretty entertaining, because then you can shoot and kind of make your plan before they do anything. Meh. That was too low. I'm focusing here, lady. Jugular is a good shot on most of these games, like, you know, real life, but I actually prefer to stab them. Right, this game's a little gory, I'm not gonna lie. And this one's probably the most one I get forgot where I'm at, because I like just try to run around and shoot, and then I'll end up looking and figuring out I'm like way out of my play area. But anyway, drop the sword for a second. So if you look, kind of shows you lightning bolt, and you're supposed to be able to do something and activate it. And I'll be honest, I've yet to figure it out. I don't know. I don't really get it. And then each one of these is kind of different. So stop that. Stop that. So B button was what I just pushed, kind of noticed, pushed it like in a slow motion type thing. There's not really much to this game, but it is kind of fun to look at. It's one of the first few games that actually got introduced with the knuckle, all four fingers tracking. So you can kind of do like jump and grabs and can climb on this game, which is fairly entertaining. So the left one kicks, right one jumps. That's what I was trying to do this whole damn time. And I was trying to see if this one had like a wall I could show you the climbing, but oh, that'll work. Hold on. So it doesn't work out great, but you can actually, if I'm off the wall, climb up these things, which is pretty cool. Like I said, there's still some physics to learn on these games, but then if you hit the button and go back home, you'll see it's trying to load right there, put you into a little waiting area, which like I said, is interchangeable. Ta-da. And you're back in your own system, so there are like two new games I just bought that I want to try on here, but I'm not going to try with you because usually it takes me 20 minutes to figure out what's going on with them. You don't want to sit here and watch that. Shutdown process is pretty simple in all these. It's just that same button to start them up turns each one off. You can either turn that off officially or you can just unplug it from this. Everybody says both of them work. I probably, like I said, in total have about 97 different things on here. I had to delete my Steam account at one point because it glitched out. So I had to re-download everything for that Beat Saber app and all these new games that I downloaded. So there's like 99 games probably in here, but not all of them have been re-downloaded because I don't play them all, obviously, a lot. But that Beat Drop right there is an app basically to go into and download songs specifically for the Beat Saber game. I mean, if we had to rank it, let's see. Turning back your direction and starting a cigarette because you know I smoke, so whatever. Beat Saber is probably my favorite game. I can easily play, like I said, 4 or 5 hours on that game. That sword game is fun 3 or 4 rounds and it gets tiring. That boxing game I always forget about, play it again, and I'm into it like for like 4 or 5 matches when my arms are dead. There's another game on here that I really like that I didn't show you, but it's called Planks Not Included, and it's like a height game. So you're on this plank and you got a net in one hand and you're basically walking out on this plank trying to catch these two little hummingbirds that pop up on two different sides of you. And you're always somewhere high above the ground, but that game is really good if you don't like heights. It's also a very trippy type game to play. Raw Data is a pretty fun shooter type. You're just like set in the future and you're basically trying to stop this evil corporation of robots. Reminds me of pretty much every movie I've ever seen ever with robots. But yeah. I just downloaded Pavlov, which is supposed to be basically like the closest thing you can play to online shooting games like Call of Duty. So like you're in these games actually shooting people from real life, which is pretty cool because these games don't have a lot of multiplayer edition. When I bought these new $300 controllers, it came with a Half-Life Alyx or something like that, Alyx or something like that. I've only ever played one of the Half-Life games in my life. I know you're like in the futuristic setting and it looks like you always shoot bugs and monsters and stuff, but that's the first full game that's going to be coming to VR, so that'll hopefully tumbleweed effect. Stupid thing about these remotes is they came out with the idea and the technology of these remotes with the finger tracking before they came out with games, so that's why there's only 2 or 3 of them that work with it. I mean, there's other games that they've kind of incorporated it that you can use now, you know, just to grip it and stuff like that. The nice thing about it is when you actually grip it without actually having those buttons on it, like the old ones used to, is it actually gives you like a sense, like it actually vibrates at you. But yeah, like I said, eventually I'll show you maybe more on this stuff. It's getting kind of late and I'm sure this video is already long as it is, but how long are we at?
59 minutes.
No way.
59 minutes and 25 seconds.
Well, okay, give me the camera. Give me the phone, don't turn it off. The woman behind the scenes.
The woman behind the scenes has been sitting in the garage and the garage cooked to the outside and the outside to freeze.
So what do you think?
VR?
Yeah.
Well, duh. I don't don't get into it as much as she does. I am not one that's ever been a huge fan of first-person shooters. There are games on there I'll play. I get into Beat Saber, like she said. That's probably one of the funnest ones. There's, like, one where you're... Think of it like paint, old school paint program, but you're virtually in it, and so you can paint and color, and that one's kind of cool. It's like a virtual paint place where you can do actual sculptures and stuff. Mine usually end up just being weird swirls that I make large and small and large and small, trip my eyes out. The only gun game I really do like is it's like an old school Western called Gunslinger, where the bullets aren't really bolts, they more look like ping pong balls, so you can deflect them with your gun, and it's like set up that you're basically telling the story to your grandson about your old days in the West. They of course incorporate other things and different types of people come at you. That one's, I will play that one. That one's fun. I haven't tried Arizona Sunshine. I don't do the jump scare games, zombie games, those type of games. We tried last night, Emily Wants to Play, which we tried once before, and, you know, I scream horribly. I don't mean like, I mean like, but a loud, high-pitched, even worse than that. And I can't hold it back, so it just kind of happens. So one thing I dislike about that shooting game with the cowboys is they kind of appear sometimes on the side and scare the crap out of me. But I'm working on it. I like more probably, a good point, I probably like more of the experiences on there. The ones where you're sitting there and you can play with particles in the air and throw them and freeze them. Ones where you're in giant stage and you can change everything about it. Mixing
oceans.
There's one with an ocean, which is really cool because you get to poke the jellyfish. That's like my favorite thing to do is poke the jellyfish. I've tried the Plankton Quitter one. That one has some of the jump scares that I'm not too okay with, and I'm not good with heights, so sometimes that gives me vertigo. She just got a Spider-Man game today that I was trying once I figured out how to load the web. That was retarded. But that was kind of fun. How he walks on the ground when he runs. Oh my God, that gave me vertigo. I was so nauseous. Did you do that where he runs on the ground?
It's what I said. It reminds me of watching Limitless, that scene where he goes through like the city and it just keeps flashing at him faster and faster.
I don't know. It's tripping me out, though.
That is a good thing to state on this game. Some people cannot play it because it gives them motion sickness and upset stomach.
Or seizures, I would not, is it epilepsy? Yeah, epilepsy is the one which, with, yeah. I would stay away from it because it does. I mean, your screen is 2 inches away from your eyes, and even it goes from black to bright white because that's when the game starts up. So maybe not things, what's that called? Motion sickness is a thing on it. It sounds odd, but it's a thing.
I've never personally been affected except for maybe a few games like she hasn't. But there's some people I've got to play this game that literally put it down after 10 minutes.
They couldn't, yeah, they were sick the rest of the night. So it really just depends on the person. It comes with the pad. Again, it is funny. Like she said, you have to find the perfect spot for your eye level to get it to be clear. And then even when it does, things sometimes hinder your view. So it can be kind of a pain to figure that out. Me personally, my ponytail is always a problem. My eyelashes are long, so it'll hit it. With Beat Saber, we sweat, no joke. So we have this as a hairband kind of right here to prevent sweat from going down around the mask. Because we have done that where we just pass the mask back and forth and it's gross.
And sweat gets into your eyeballs.
And so then you'll feel sweat in your eyeballs or this will start to crouch down over the view and then you have to fix it. But for the most part, it's pretty fun.
Beat Saber VR is one of those things I'd say if you're interested in it, try a demo, find a friend first, because it's not a cheap alternative. I mean, when I first got this system, I've had it over a year now, and I did not play it very much when I first got it. It's something I've newly got into, because she doesn't like to play it all the time, and I always feel bad out here playing it. But I'll honestly say, out of every single video game system I've owned, I probably play it more now than any other one, besides maybe old school Nintendo when me and her were younger. But out of all the current game systems, it's probably the funnest, and it is because you're actually in the game. I mean, it's really hard to explain just you looking at a view. I mean, I watch tons of these videos.
It's virtual reality. I mean, you can see what she sees on the screen, like the archery one where you're seeing those people in the distance. But for when you're in the helmet, you're actually seeing that. I mean, it's 3D spatial reality. So if something's 5 feet away on the game, it's literally 5 feet from you. You can look over things. You can look across cities, down buildings. It's VR.
Yeah, but like I said, if you're really interested in it, find a friend first, because it's not a cheap setup. It definitely is.
I know at one point Samsung had...
Samsung had like
that was our first thing with it, which I really liked that one. They had like a Google Earth one that was on it. That was really fun.
There's also a new one coming out called Oculus Quest, which is actually probably going to be... I hate to be blunt, it's probably going to blow HTC out of the Vive, and the reason is because it doesn't run off a PC. You can play these powerful games, and it runs off your phone. Now, I don't know, from what I could tell, you basically had to set it up on your Wi-Fi, and then you download it straight to, like, the helmet and played games off of it, so it might take a little bit longer, but I feel like, for any of you geeks out there that've seen Ready Player One, as much as I joke about it, I feel like that might become our future, only because a lot of the stuff that's happened in that video game is starting to come to pass. I mean, some of the newer things you can buy on these VR systems are amazing. You can buy... Yeah, you take it. You take it. You can buy literally track pads that go around your belt, and literally you can run on it in real life, but the track pad keeps you in the same spot, which direction you want to go, and you can run. You can buy suits now that you put over your shirt, and when you get shot, it actually pings you. I mean, the fact of how real life they're making these, I've seen videos on here where people literally spend 2 weeks straight in the helmet. They find apps where you can sleep in a bed, find apps where you can zen out, find apps where you can play. I saw some guy play Minecraft half the video, and it's amazing because you really can sit in these things for hours at a time, and when you get out of it, you're like, oh, you're in real life. It's boring now. I mean, the reality of these games are amazing. I do wish they'd start making games that last a little bit longer and making games that were more realistic. Because like she said, the experience games are kind of my favorite, but they're always like these short little things. And Everest One's kind of, a lot of these games are like factual games you play. They have everything on these systems. Fruit Ninja, escape games, horror games, action games. Games that are literally just climbing games, swinging games, running games. I mean, it's amazing. The developers that make these games, I mean, those games you get on your phone where you're making sandwiches and, you know, playing food games. You can do that in VR now. One of the first games I ever got for this VR type world is actually on my PlayStation 1, but it's, what's it called? Job Simulator. And, like, in this world, it's like 2029 is the year, and basically robots are in control. And so you're a human that's serving robots now. And so you work at a supermarket and a car place and a hotel and a restaurant. And it's just, it's cool. It's very cool. And like I said, eventually I will shoot a video and show you all my games. This video's going a little bit long. I knew it was going to do, so I'm going to cut it off here. But I would say give it a shot. You're not going to miss out. Maybe it's not something you want to do all the time, but that's just fine, because most of the time you're not going to want to do it all the time. I feel like in 15 years, these game systems are going to be a lot easier to use, a lot better for the average person. Like I said, the setup originally costed me, if you already had the computer and everything, was $1,200. All that Oculus Quest, the newer, but all the Oculus systems are $340. I personally think the Vive looks better. And if you look at it, they say it has better graphics. But that's coming one-sided, because I've only played with an Oculus once in the store. That's actually how this started, was after we had the PlayStation, we went to our mall, Clackamas Town Center, and sat in there with me, her, and one of our friends for almost an hour, and kept going back and playing these games in there. And it's just, once you're in the games, you don't want to leave them. You do get tired in them. I feel like eventually they're going to come out with like an exercise game on this. They already have, but a full exercise game on this, it could actually do you some good. I've seen people play these Beat Saber games just to lose weight, kind of like DDR Max when they first came out. People have lost 200 pounds just playing these games. I mean, it's amazing software that's coming out. And like I said, 20, 30 years on the road, it'll probably be a lot of people will have these things on their face. For a while, they kind of thought this technology would die, nobody would really like it. But now there's 20, at least 20 different head VR systems out there you can get now. Back, you know, 2 years ago when this came out, there were 3. So people really do like VR. It's probably going to come more mainstream. I mean, the amazing thing about these is the technology on them. I like to watch videos where that's why I like having other people here to make them come in and try these, because they're so amazed by how it looks when you get into it. Because even, like I said, watching it is nothing like when you're inside of it. I mean, I had my grandparents come and play the one inside the house, and just their reactions alone made the system worth it. I mean, it's cool.
It's very cool.
Hopefully you guys enjoyed this.
I can't really think of anything else to add. Like I said, I'll shoot another video eventually on it, but I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys want to give it a shot, find someone you know that has it. It's really worth your time.
Let us know what you think about us, our venturing out a little bit.
Yeah, let us know what you think of the VR video. If you guys like them, I mean, there's whole people that dedicate their channels to it. Not saying that's what we're going to do, but if you guys like it, we'll go through and shoot a video of us game playing every single game we have. That's at least 96 videos. Anyway, let us know what you think. If you like the VR stuff, we'll start incorporating into our channel. We might as well. We have the whole system anyway. The only real challenge we have at our particular house with VR is we have it out in the garage. So when our parents get annoyed of our dogs in the house, we can't play because you risk rocking on them because obviously you can't see them. And it is in the garage. So when it's 27 degrees outside, it's 28 degrees in the garage and it's too cold to play. When it hits summer and it's 110 degrees, it's 112 degrees in the garage. So out here is a little bit harder to play. If it was a house set up, you'd have a little bit easier time, I think. But we don't really have any place in our house big enough for it. And like I said, I did not want to get one where I just stood around. I want one where I can walk and do all this stuff. But yeah, like she said, let us know what you think of the video. Let us know what you think of VR. If you want us to choose more, we will do that. And if you made it all the way through this video and all this rambunctious talking, good for you. I probably couldn't have. Thanks for watching.